A few minutes before trading was to end at the Bombay Stock Exchange, a massive explosion ripped the 29-story building's basement parking area. In a span of 150 minutes, the city was shaken by 12 more blasts along its entire length, leaving behind more than 300 people dead, more than 1,500 injured, and a trail of gruesome destruction.
It all began when Haneef Karawala and Sameer Hingora, film producers with strong underworld links, were arrested in connection with the Bombay blasts. They revealed that out of the 9 AK-56s they possessed, they had sold one to Sanjay Dutt.
And these weapons were part of that consignment which was used in the bomb blast. So this is how Sanjay Dutt was roped into the case.
According to the police, Sanjay behaved like a professional criminal rather than a film hero, especially when he tried to get rid of the AK-56. On his instructions, his two friends melted the gun, but the police managed to recover its spring from them.
Now, this weapon has never been used, and there's no evidence that it was likely to be used or was used. If you ask me, it's using a sledgehammer to crack a nut.
Sanjay Dutt's arrest under TADA for acquiring an illicit AK-56 from smugglers and trying to get rid of it through an underworld contact has focused the entire country's attention on the long flourishing relationship between the Bombay film industry and the underworld. Was Sanjay just being foolishly macho, or was he actually involved in a dangerous anti-national plot? Ranjana Jaitley investigates.
One AK-56, without a single shot being fired, achieved what the entire government machinery could not. In one blow, it exposed the thriving nexus between the film world and the underworld, the other face of Bollywood, shady, sordid and sinister.
There was a time where they infiltrated into the film industry and it used to be so bad, we were forced to work for the movies they wanted us to work. This much money, no money.
Sanjay Dutt had gone for shooting to Dubai. Many films used to go for shootings there and Dawood Ibrahim used to invite them to his house.
I do what I feel is right. If I'm convinced that I'm right, I'd do it, no matter if it's wrong or what.
The reason given by Sanjay for acquiring an AK-56 was that he did it to protect his family after they received threats for helping riot victims in Bombay in January.
Help in your capacity. And my capacity was this much. I tried to go this much. And that's how I ended up in this problem.
He was getting a lot of threatening calls.
Basically helped humanity, human beings, you know. I didn't think about a Hindu and a Muslim and this and that. I don't know. I mean, there's nothing wrong in helping. And it just gets you into trouble.
The press managed to get their hands on photographs which were shot for the film.
He bent down and he kissed my fingers and it was horrible. He bent down and he kissed my fingers and it was horrible.
Prison is scary anyway, so when you enter a prison, I mean, you're scared. Especially a person who's not a habitual criminal or it's his first time and stuff like that. And then to be put in a high security barrack where these, well, there used to be calls like, how we'll kill you and your family, and they knew exactly where my nieces were studying, they knew the movements of my family members, they knew everything. So it became really scary for us, basically. And they had said that, you know, like, there'll be about 200 guys who come rape your sisters, and we'll do this and we'll do that. Just to pinpoint down that, okay, that's the school your nieces go to, and your sister leaves the house between 10 to 11, and you know, all that kind of information which was right, that was scary. They sort of have these militants there. Yeah, it's the shape of an egg. And there were three doors, and before you enter that barrack, and there are these grills on top where they have these, you know, Central Reserve Police patrolling all over. And you're locked up in your cell, and you're allowed just 15 minutes in the morning and 15 minutes in the evening to come out. So basically, you're under lock and key the whole day. It's really, really, it's, it sort of breaks you mentally.
When they handcuffed my son, at that time I felt that somebody is actually hanging all my dignity and all my honor and whatever I've done for the country. And you know, there I couldn't hold my emotions at that time, which I wanted to, because I felt if anything I do, it might affect my son. He might become weaker. And I couldn't hold my tears at that time, and he looked at me. He understood.
You know, see, it's a funny kind of a game between an accused who's inside and the family who's outside. It's sad, and it's, I don't know, it's funny. Because some you feel, you know, you don't want to emote that much for them to get worried on the outside, and because they can't do anything. They feel that, you know, we should go and not cry in front of the guy because he shouldn't get upset inside. So we both are sitting and acting our parts, you know.
I always would tell him, you must convince yourself mentally that behind this wall, your father is there. Whether you get up in the night at 12 o'clock, you feel that your father is there, and I will be there. I guarantee you. And so many times, in the dead of night, I used to drive to Thane, and I used to park my car outside the walls and all. Sometimes I used to go around, but there's a road going around for a while. So I used to go around and come back. I generally felt that he must be getting that feel that somebody is there around me.
I learned one thing, that I was alone in jail. See, it was just me. Okay. And what I was feeling, nobody could feel. Not anybody. Not my dad. Not my sisters. Nobody.
After 15 months in prison, bail was finally granted. Sanjay was released to a rapturous welcome. He can now walk free in Bombay, but can do little else. He has to be in court every day that the trial runs. With over 2,500 witnesses for the prosecution alone, the bomb blast conspiracy trial looks set to become the longest in legal history. Sanjay could be attending court for the next 18 years.
Whatever my son has suffered, is suffered because of me, because of my ideologies, my thinking, and my whatever I did, you know, for the common people and all. And it's the suffering went to him. That's why I feel more sad, because he's the type of guy who doesn't know anything about politics and who doesn't actually never indulge in politics.
I don't know anything.
No comments, please, nothing. That's all now. Thanks.
Sunil Dutt's son, found to be identified with the criminals involved in the bomb blast, was not immediately necessarily bought as a fact, but it was extremely convenient to buy.
Media attention was so much focused on him that overnight he had become the terrorist who had bombed the city. You can call it fate, or you can call it a price that you pay for your success. The kingpins, they've not managed to arrest. They're all absconding. And the biggest name, I mean, which people could identify with was Sanjay Dutt.
I go to court every day and I see the proceedings. Nobody's taken my name. They have two approvers. They don't mention me. They've questioned about 70 witnesses. Nobody knows who I am. I don't know how I'm there, but I'm there.
Frankly, I wasn't very surprised because he's already been mixed up with such a lot of things. It wasn't a surprise as such.
Well, it came as a shock to me.
मेरे हिसाब से फंसाया गया उसे.
I thought that if he has done something wrong, उसको punishment मिलनी चाहिए उसके लिए. I mean, just because of his superior position as Sanjay Dutt, the actor, he should not be protected.
बहुत से लोगों को ये विश्वास भी नहीं है कि संजय दत्त देशद्रोही हो सकता है.
ना देखो मुझे ऐसी नजर से, ना देखो मुझे ऐसी नजर से, वक्त का मारा हूँ मैं, एक बेचारा हूँ मैं नादा हूँ यारो, नहीं दिल का बुरा हूँ, किस्मत का मारा हूँ मैं, एक बेचारा हूँ मैं, ना देखो मुझे ऐसी नजर से. अनजानी भूल क्या क्या गुल खिलाती है, जीवन की भरी खुशियों में आग लगाती है, सोच के अपनी गलती को आंखें भर आती है, आंखें भर आती है, न देखो मुझे ऐसी नजर से, वक्त का मारा हूँ मैं, एक बेचारा हूँ मैं, न देखो मुझे ऐसी नजर से. के आदर्शों को मैं भटका नादा, माँ की ममता रूठ गई तब आया मुझे ज्ञान, अपने ही हाथों से फिर अपनी किस्मत सवारी. पर किस्मत का मारा हूँ मैं, एक बेचारा हूँ मैं, ना देखो मुझे ऐसी नजर से. चाहा जब भी जैसा उसने वो कर डाला, कैसे दुश्मन बनूं मैं उसका जिसने दिया निवाला, इम्तिहान की आज घड़ी है, किसका लूं मैं सहारा, किसका लूं मैं सहारा, ना देखो मुझे ऐसी नजर से, वक्त का मारा हूँ मैं, ए बेचारा हूँ मैं नादा हूँ यारो, नहीं दिल का बुरा हूँ, किस्मत का मारा हूँ मैं, ए बेचारा हूँ मैं, न देखो मुझे ऐसी नजर से, न देखो मुझे ऐसी नजर से, न देखो मुझे ऐसी नजर से।